She is already serving 26 years for murder, but now Amanda Knox is accused of another crime and faces a new trial in Italy. A hearing on the case is scheduled for Monday. NBC's Nina DeRoy has the story.
6 months after her conviction for murder, Amanda Knox will take the stand once more. This time, she faces a new charge, slander, after claiming Italian police struck her during her questioning.
The authorities are saying is, yes, we have a murder conviction, but you also lied to us, and now we're going to go after you for that as well.
The case has attracted unprecedented interest on both sides of the Atlantic, with Knox branded either a cold-blooded killer or an innocent victim of flawed Italian justice. The State Department has even been asked to intervene.
There's no question that Amanda Knox got an unfair rap from the media in many European countries. And I think that that led to a sort of thirst for a conviction by many in Europe.
Knox's student days came to an abrupt end in November 2007 when the body of her British roommate, Meredith Kircher, was found in a pool of blood at the cottage they shared. Forensic evidence showed she'd been sexually assaulted. Her throat had been slashed. Two others were also convicted, Knox's former Italian boyfriend, Raffaele Sollecito, and Rudy Guedi, a drifter from the Ivory Coast. All three deny killing her and are appealing their convictions.
The defense argues a lack of motive and shoddy DNA evidence will exonerate Amanda Knox. Many also believe that language barriers affected her testimony, giving a different impression of the 22-year-old.
But Italian prosecutors are adamant that's not the case, claiming she had a translator present throughout her questioning. Amanda Knox is expected to appeal her conviction in the fall. Even if she does win her bid for freedom, one thing's for certain, her life will never be the same. For today, Nina DeRoy, NBC News London.
Joining us from Seattle are Amanda's parents, Kurt Knox and Etta Mellis. Good morning to both of you. Thanks for being with us.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Kurt, I know you get a weekly phone call, or Amanda gets a 10-minute weekly phone call on Saturdays. You've been able to speak to her. Can you describe her state of mind these days?
Well, she's actually doing better on a day-to-day basis. It's a circumstance where when the verdict was rendered, it was very devastating to her. But she's now looking forward to the appeal and hopefully getting a chance to come home.
And Ed, I know your husband, Amanda's stepdad, has taken up permanent residence in Italy and was able to visit her recently during one of her allowed monthly visits. What did he describe?
Actually, I just got a text message before I came in here, and then the last couple of visits have been good. She's been a little bit more upbeat. You know, she has her ups and downs, and right now she's doing okay.
Let's talk about this slander issue right now. There's a hearing coming up. I know one of the points in dispute, you want the judge removed. Why, and what do you think the chances are?
Well, the judge has already rendered decisions related to Amanda's case, so having her continue on the stand at this point in time, we believe we should have a new judge and Amanda should have an opportunity for an independent review.
And Anna, we should clear up. These are charges related to statements that Amanda made about the way police treated her when they first took her into custody.
Right, right. You know, it's interesting. Amanda has been saying the same thing since the day she was, interrogated, the morning after her interrogation. She's maintained the same story about how she was treated and how that interrogation went. And when she had the opportunity to defend herself on the stand, she again said the same thing she's always said. And because of that, she's now been charged with slander.
And Kurt, the larger issue, of course, is, certainly in your opinion, to getting her exonerated. The appeals process has been crawling along. Can you tell us where that stands?
Well, at this point in time, they still have not identified the two judges that are going to be on the appeals trial, and we're still waiting for a date, but we're hoping it's going to start in the latter portion of September, early October of this year.
Etta, for a lot of us who have looked at this case, I think one of the troubling aspects is we can't help but look through this through the lens of American justice. And this is not American justice, it's Italian justice. Have you been able to finally focus and look at it through an Italian point of view?
You know, yeah, I think we've learned a lot about how the Italian judicial system works. And, you know, it is definitely different. And I think in ways that, you know, it's better. I think their appeal process is stronger. You know, so that's what we're really focusing on now.
And, Curtinette, I'm going to ask you this question. I suspect you're going to want to really talk about this because there have been charges, accusations out there that the two of you have been shopping Amanda's story for cash. And how do you respond to those reports?
Yeah. It's absolutely false. However that's been reported of us shopping around, an interview with Amanda is completely false. This is not about money. It's about bringing Amanda home where she belongs.
You know, we've been offered, actually, and we have never, ever accepted any money for any interview.
Well, listen, I know the two of you are living every parent's worst nightmare. We appreciate you spending time with us. Kurt Knox, Adam Ellis, thanks so much.
Thank you for having us.